Welcome
to Brain Snacks!
Have you ever asked yourself what music actually is? I mean in terms of physics. I don't want to ruin the romance and fun of music, of course, but the explanation how music actually works might give you another viewpoint on it, or hearpoint.
Here are some music / acoustic basics. If someone sings a tone or plays it with an instrument, the air molecules around start oscillating. They do it in a periodical way, so the oscillation can be described with an acoustic wave. One of the most important characteristics of an acoustic wave is its frequency. It indicates how often the wave occurs in a certain amount of time. Also, the period of a wave is important. It is the time needed for one cycle of the wave, and the relationship between the frequency and the period is reciprocal. For example, wave 1 occurs 2 times in 1 second, and wave 2 occurs 4 times in 1 second. So wave 1 has a frequency of 2 per second and a period of a half second, and wave 2 has a frequency of 4 per second and a period of 1/4 of a second. The unit per second is also called hertz. A piano has tones from approximately 16 to 5,500 hertz, and the higher the frequency, the higher is the tone.
Let's listen to some chords now, and for that I asked two very talented singers to join me.
Hi, I'm Simon.
Hi, I'm Moritz.
1, 2, 3, 4.
The question arising is, why do these chords sound so good for our ears? So each tone has a different frequency, and if they're played or sang together, the acoustic waves of the single tones influence each other and they form a new wave that is the superposition of the single waves. Let's look at the example on my left. The two tones are a C and an E. This musical interval is called a third. An acoustic wave that corresponds to a note of that C has a frequency of 132 Hz, and that E has a frequency of 165 Hz.
So the frequency of E is the frequency of C times 5/4. That means that the superposed wave will repeat every 4 periods of C or every 5 periods of E. And as you can see, it has a regular pattern.
Our ears really like regular stuff, so that is why it sounds so good. It is similar with a C and a G played or sang together. The interval between these notes is called a fifth.
The frequency of G is the frequency of C times 3/2. So the superposed wave repeats after 2 periods of C or 3 periods of G.
As you can see, also this pattern looks pretty regular, and therefore the two notes played together sound good. One example for a wave pattern that is not so regular is that one of a tritone, formed for example with a C and an F sharp. You hear immediately that it doesn't sound so nice.
The frequency ratio of these notes is 45 to 32. That means that the pattern just repeats every 32 periods of C or every 45 periods of F sharp, and that explains the not so pleasant sounding interval.
The chords we sang on the beginning of this episode were major chords, and they always consist of a root for the chord, a third, and a fifth. The superposed waves form a regular pattern, and that is why the chord sounds good. Makes sense, right? I hope you enjoyed watching this video. This topic was completely new to me. I just studied some theory of harmony playing the piano, but I never looked at the math and physics of it. Please let me know in the comments if you would like me to do more videos about this topic or write an email to info@brainsnacks.science. I find it really interesting and fascinating, so let me know if you share my excitement. You can also follow Brain Snacks on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter, and the links are in the description of this video. I also want to thank Moritz and Simon for helping me with this video. I had a lot of fun, and if you want to see more of them, they have some really cool bands. Simon's band is called Cosmos Super and Moritz's band is called Soundkönig. And the links are in the description of this video. This was Clara from Brain Snacks. Bye bye!